Yo YouTube, I'm back again with another video. This is my YouTube disclaimer. Warning, this video may have very strong language and may not be suitable for younger viewers. Age tag recommendation 18 plus. Please watch the video with a pinch of salt and don't take anything to heart. This is just me and my friends having fun on games and showing you the playback in true HD. Nothing malicious. If we do have content that's swearing or being verbally abusive, it's just something that we do as banter between us as friends. So I'd like to say, please comment, rate and subscribe. A big thank you to my viewers, and I hope you enjoy the video that follows on to this one. Peace out, bitches. Oh yeah, it's fucking gaming time and it's all about the fucking disclaimer. Peace out, bitches. Ta-ta. Yo, 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 YouTube, I'm back again with another video, and this time this one's going to be how to install Command & Conquer Red Alert 3 mods for Windows 10 for Steam, for Origin, or for a retail copy. I'm going to show you how to do it all here in this video, hopefully under in 10 minutes. We're going to start first with installing it on Origin, and then let's go from there. So let me just minimize a couple of my boxes on this screen and let's get to my workstation screen. So first off, what I would like you to do is go to the start here button, and just below it there's a search window, magnifying glass, whatever you want to call it. Just go in there and type in control panel. Now control panel normally is on, sorry about that, I was just talking. The control panel is normally on a shortcut key, but sometimes it's not there, and Windows 10 hasn't got a shortcut on your desktop as such. So like I say, go in there, press control panel, type in control panel and you'll see it come up. I've already got a shortcut on my desktop here, so I'm going to use that. But you get to control panel by typing in here. And then when you're in here, you want to go to File Explorer Options, and then you want to get this box here that pops up and go to View and go Show Hidden Folders, Files and Drives. Once you've got that one shown, click Apply, click OK, it'll flash your screen a couple of times and that's that one done. That's that done out of the way. You need to have that just in case you want to go into the user data and unlock your maps and just change a couple of bits and bobs. I would always have that showing. Pardon me. Right, let's get down to the doing it on Origin. So as you can see, the first thing that you'd need to do when you're on Origin, so as you can see, I'm logged into Origin here. This is my game collection. I'm going to get RA3. The first thing you need to do is download it. As you can see, mine's done downloading. I want you to go and hover above the emblem of RA3 and click the I, and then go in game properties and then type in here space minus UI and click apply. That's that done. So what's going to happen now, you're thinking to yourself? Well, what we've just done there is we can go on to RA3 and click apply, and it's going to bring up this box here. Now we can access our mods. All we'd have to do is drop the mods in, so that's what we're going to go do now. So I'm just going to bring up my backup drive that I've got here, and I'm going to go into CNC mods, and I'm going to go into Red Alert 3 mods, which is here, and these are all my mods that I play on, and this is going to be my first install of mods on Windows 10. I haven't played no mods yet on this build of Windows 10. I've played it on previous builds but not this build. I wanted to do a fresh install of the mods to show you lot. So when you've got your mods downloaded, whichever website you want to go get them from, if you're going to mod your game, you know what mod you're looking on, so you've already got your mod, or I'll give a link in the description below where you can get your mods from. So after you've got this box running and you can see all this information, and then you've got your mods that you want, what I would like you to do is on this taskbar here, you'll have pinned there, you'll have a folder. Just right click that folder and it will bring up a box like this. And then you need to go into documents. But you can also type documents in here and it will bring up your documents. You can also go to this computer and go to documents this way. So this is what we're going to do. Right, so I've got documents up on this side. Let's snap that and let's snap this. I've got documents up on this side. You want to make a f if when you come to play your Red Alert and you can't see this folder. I've had a couple of queries before and a couple of questions before. If you can't see this Red Alert 3 folder, just make one. Just put a capital R E D capital A L E R T space 3. Open it up, make your own mods folder, and then all you have to do is drag and drop your mods in. It's going to take a minute, but I am transferring a lot of mods here. We're talking about 4.5 gig of mods, which is not going to take too long. But while that's transferring, I need to make sure that when you create this folder, it is exactly the same as mine here. So I've got documents, Red Alert 3, mods, and then I've dropped the mods in there. So when that's done, copying and pasting over, we're gonna load. Well, we could actually load it now. Let's close this back down. And let's try and load RA3 and let's see what it says now. RA3, the box has popped up. Browse, mods. And as you can see, look, my mods have all dropped in. Lovely. So that shows you that it does work, and that's how you get your mods on Origin. Now, people may be thinking, oh, well, I haven't got Origin, but I've got Steam. Well, let me show you how to do it on Steam. Pull up my library. Very easily. All you've got to do is install your Red Alert 3 again, like I've just said. When you've installed it, right click it, go to properties, go to launch options, and put in space minus UI. Okay. Close down, play. I'm gonna have to ask for the agreement because I've not loaded the game before on this system. Like I say, this system, I've had previous builds of Windows 10 and I've tried all the CNCs and they work fine. But these are new fresh installs that I've been doing in the past couple of days. So let me just get this box up here. And I don't normally do this, but I'm just gonna flatten my friends list a minute. Just make it a bit smaller. And there we go, look. I'm in Red Alert 3. As you can see there, Command and Conquer Red Alert 3 on Steam. And then I'm gonna show you the mods. So there we go. Browse game. Boom. Mods. You've got mods. So all you have to do is do the same process as Origin, but when you come to putting your UI in, minus space minus UI, you've got to put it in the Steam property. Now, some people may be thinking, oh shit, I haven't got Origin, but I haven't got Steam. So what do I do? Well, the best thing to do then is that you've got to create a manual shortcut, and I'm going to show you how to create this manual shortcut now. You need to find where you've installed your game to. Most of the time it's C drive, most of the time it's a personal drive that you've picked from. Now in this case it's going to be my personal drive. So for personal reasons, I'm just going to go into my Steam library, common, apps, Red Alert 3. And then you may be thinking, oh, what do I do from here if I've got a retail version? Well, all you need to do is right click your application loader, create a shortcut. There we go, create a shortcut. And then open this shortcut up with properties. And then at the end of this, put space minus UI. Click apply, OK, and then boom, there you go, lot. This is I've forced Red Alert 3 to load in my Steam directory, so so none of my friends could see that I'm playing CNC at the moment. But that's the way that you do it with a retail version. You've got to go into the source directory, create a shortcut, add the command line on, browse your games, launch your mods, and Bob's your uncle. That is exactly how you install mods, ladies and gentlemen, for Windows 10, for Steam, Origin, and a retail copy. If there's any more questions, will you please put them in the box below and I'll do my ultimate best to help you out. There will be plenty of more videos coming. There will be a world builder fix for Windows 10. There will be a Tiberian Wars mod installer for all of the categories against that Steam, Origin, retail copy. So as always, YouTube, please comment, rate, and subscribe. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope this helps you out on Windows 10. All the information will be posted in the box below for links, for mods, for game installs, for the descriptions. So I'm out of here, bitches. Peace out. I hope you enjoy yourselves. And as always, thank you for watching the video. Ta-ta, bitches. Peace out. Oh, yeah. It's gaming time.